Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the group 13 elements, as well as we have also discussed about the various compounds that were been belonging to group 13 elements, and now we are going to talk about the group 14 elements. So what are the group 14 elements, as well as what is the general electronic configuration of those elements? Let us talk about that. So talking about the elements that are belonging to group 14, they are as carbon, silicon, germanium, tin and lead. So these are the symbols that I have mentioned over here, and basically tin is basically, it is represented by SN, that represents for the ancient name, that is stannous, and that's the reason that we have made a symbolic representation of those elements. And now we are going to talk about what are the general electronic configuration. But before representing the general electronic configuration, we should understand that what is the atomic number of this each elements. So it has been found that the atomic number of the carbon, it has been found to be, because I am representing the atomic number, so therefore it has been found to be 6. For silicon, it has been found to be 14. So this is the atomic number that I have represented over here, and that is for carbon it is 6, for silicon it is 14, and for germanium 32, tin that is 50, and lead that is 82. So this is what we have represented about the atomic number. And when we are going to talk about the electronic configuration, so it has been found that it is very easy to estimate the electronic configuration, as well as to represent the electronic configuration, and that could be represented as, for carbon we could represent it as 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. For silicon, it is also very easy, that is to understand, that is, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p2. And for germanium, it has been found to be, that is, we could also write the electronic configuration in this manner, that is, argon, which has an atomic number of 18, so argon 18, 3d10, 4s2, 4p2. And for tin, we have, that is, krypton, 4d10, 5s2, 5p2. And for ultimately for that is lead, we have, that is, xenon, and this is basically, we could represent it as 5d10, 6s2 and 6p2. So this is what we have represented, the electronic configuration of the elements that have been belonging to group 14. But if you observe this electronic configuration, so this is very much similar that we have did in our previous lecture for group 13, but in that case we have also discussed only the general electronic configuration. But let me discuss that, how can we calculate the general electronic configuration over here. So if you talk about the first carbon atom, then in this case basically the ultimate shell, or the last shell that we have, that is 2s2 and 2p2. So in the last shell, that are, there are two that is two subshells, that is one is S and the other is P subshell. And in this case basically you could see that again in S orbital that consists of two electrons, and for P orbitals also that consists of two electrons, or P subshell that consists of two electrons. So similarly, as you move down the group, that is from carbon to silicon, the ultimate shell, it increases by one. So means the ultimate shell or the last shell is second shell, this is the third shell, this is fourth, fifth and sixth. So this is how the number of shell, it increases down the group. And meanwhile, we could say that the general electronic configuration, or the general electronic configuration for the valence shell, could be represented as NS2 and NP2. So this is what the group 14 elements have, the general electronic configuration for the valence shell, if you are concerned with that one. And since the last electron enters in the P subshell, or enters in the P orbital, that's the reason it is known as P block element, and that is what we know the definition. So that is an introduction of group 14 elements. But let me talk about the another properties also, that how they are being classified in such categories, or in different kind of categories. So let me talk about the carbon and silicon. So these two elements are basically, they are non-metals. While talking about germanium and that is tin, they are basically since germanium and tin, they are basically used in used in semiconductors, therefore we could say that in this case germanium is basically a metalloid. While talking about tin and PB, they are basically metals. So this is how they are being classified. That's the reason P block has a variety of different class of the elements. That is, one is metals, one could be a non-metal, and the others are gases like noble gases. So this is what I was talking about, the group 14 elements, and there are various properties of or various different kind of physical properties that we are going to talk about the group 14 elements, but not now in this lecture, in another one. So till then, I hope you have understood what are group 14 elements and how can we represent the electronic configuration, as well as what are the general electronic configuration of the group 14 elements. So I hope I'll see you next time, and till then, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.